Floyd. Andre has expressed before that he feels he's somewhat of a combination of yourself, and Floyd Mayweather, and Bernard Hopkins. Yeah, how do you take to that? And
well, you got to take that good, because that's what I did. I combined me a Super 6 and made Roy Jones. So he combined him a Super 3, who probably, we didn't combine us a Super 5 or 6, and he made himself Andre Ward. That's how you get better. You got to think about it. If we just, and this is a small, short example, but I'm going to show you how real I keep it. Steph Curry is an old juice version of Reggie Miller. Mm. He got the same Reggie Miller, shot Reggie Miller had, but he got handles with it. Huh? That's how you make great players. You take what was good yesterday or what was great yesterday, and you add to that. And when I say on juice or on steroids, I'm not meaning physically taking steroids on. I'm saying that player amped up to the next level. You understand me? Some players you can't amp up because they maxed out. Michael Jordan maxed out. You can take a lot of what Mike do, but Mike is maxed out. There will be no more Mikes.
Yeah.
We can forget that. Kobe was the closest we're going to get to another Mike, and he was different. You understand me? But he did max Mike out. He just was a little bit different. He took Mike and took the three-point shot a little bit further and a couple other things. But the way you get great, the way you guarantee yourself greatness is you find you two or three really great or close to great fighters, and you put all three of them in one. Now you got a super fighter. Quite obvious, right?
A lot of criticism is that fighting someone like Sullivan Barrera and Alexander Brand isn't going to get Ward ready for someone like Kovalev. Do you agree with that?
A lot of criticism is, and I ain't being small, I just haven't talked like this because this is how to speak. I know it ain't you saying it, it's your critics. And what I want to say to the critics is, when a son of a gun ain't lost since he was 14 years old and he's 32, what kind of critic, who he need to fight? Who beat him in all that time? He don't need to fight nobody, he can fight who he want to fight. Look at him.
Was it him? He just needed to get training camps in and get in the groove, basically?
No, he needed a couple fights consecutive to get the ring rust off. That's all he needed. And anybody would need that. Anybody in a good sense would need that.
How does that feel for you to see guys like Dre or anybody else who kind of look up to you?
Man, come on, bro. That's the best thing ever. You know what I mean? Just the fact I just remember them training. To see them come in and try to see how much of me they try to copy, how much they want to mimic, how much they want to understand the way I did things. Bro, it don't get no better than that. That's something that God gave me, and no credit, and nobody else can take away from me. You can't take the fact that everybody loves Roy Jones and remember Roy's moves. You can't take the fact that I love Ali and that's why I start fighting. They can't take that away.
Not even your Super 6.
We'll talk about it then.
Another guy who said he looked up to you a lot back in his country is Lomachenko. Has had a big fight against Nicholas Walters. What do you think when you see him? Do you see some of yourself? He said he watched you as a kid.
My favorite of all of them right now is him and Andre. Because I see more of me and them two than anybody else. Right.
Would you favor him over Manny Pacquiao at 135 or 140? I mean, how do you feel about that matchup?
135, 140, yes.
You would favor Lomachenko over Pacquiao? Why is that?
Because he is too much of a pugilist. He's more of a pugilist than Pacquiao is. Pacquiao had exceptional power, but Pacquiao jumped in. You timed that with Marquez, did he time that? Look what happened. You don't see Lomachenko do that jumping like that. Lomachenko. Footwork is much too good. He's never going to jump in and jump out of there. He's more of a boxing pugilist than what a person like Pacquiao. Not that Pacquiao are not good. That Pacquiao is strong as heck. So I'm not taking that away from Pacquiao, but the fight styles are a little bit different. Pacquiao's a little more of an exciting dude who kind of just erratic and you never can pick his, you never can catch his rhythm. Once the guy caught the rhythm, though, it kind of rough. Lomachenko, a whole different animal. a whole different animal. So at 35, I'll probably favor him.
And then, I mean, you trained Jesse. You saw what he did to Jesse. Yeah. And even after that, you still have Lomachenko.
What about that footwork of Lomachenko?
It's the greatest. It's the greatest. It's the greatest. Thank you. It's just that Roy Jones, you're old.
Thank you, bro. Appreciate it.